Bobcats, this is former Buffett student Anna Hayden coming back to report the news one more time. Today is Tuesday, December 4th, 2018. As always, let's begin with the daily announcements. Student Council and the Rousel Committee are organizing coins for kindness for Buffett families in need over the holiday season. Coins will be collected by Bobcat Dens through Friday, December 14th. The winning team will be rewarded with a cookie party. Book Blasters will meet this Thursday from 3:15 to 4:15 in Miss Tuning's Portable 6. Please bring back any books you are finished with so we can recirculate them. NJHS, remember that the toy drive ends this Friday. Members are required to bring two new toys each. There will be a drop-off box in the 8th grade hallway each morning this week. If you have any questions, please contact Miss Phillips. Those are the announcements for today. Now we take you to the BBTV News Desk for a quick story that you need to know.
Hey Bobcats, Adu here, back from the class of 2015, and I thought I'd stop by and give another go at BBTV. So, with Thanksgiving behind us, many students are beginning to think about what they want, what they'll be asking for this holiday season. One fun tradition many kids have is writing letters to Santa. However, in Omaha, there isn't really a place to send them. Marcy Lewis, who lives in Southwest Omaha, is hoping to change this. Beginning this year, Marcy and her family started a new tradition by putting a mailbox out on their front lawn for kids to drop off letters to Santa. This mailbox is located at their home on 168th and Giles Road and is open to any kid to place a letter to Santa in. So, Bobcats, it's time to form your opinion. If you celebrate Christmas, have you ever written a letter to Santa?
What's up, Bobcats? This is Hannah in the BBTV Sports Zone bringing you coverage of all the big things happening in the world of sports. Let's begin by checking out your Buffett Bobcats. Today there will be a boys basketball game against Bryan at home. Tomorrow there will be a swim meet against Hale and Beveridge at Hale. This will be their last meet before city finals. Finally, on Thursday, there will be another boys basketball game at Morton. Leaving Buffett, let's head over to college football. Yesterday in BBTV, you learned who won the conference championships, and today we'll be discussing who will be heading to the playoffs. It was announced that Alabama will face off Oklahoma, and Clemson will take on Notre Dame. These two games will take place Saturday, December 29th. The winners of these two games will face off for the BCS National Championship game on January 7th. That's all for sports. Now over to the BBTV Weather Lab for your three-day forecast.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is meteorologist Jennifer here for your three-day forecast. Today we will have a bitter high of only 25 and a low dipping all the way down to 16 degrees. Tomorrow will be the warmest day of the week with a high of 34 and a low of 15. Switching it up on Thursday, it will be the complete opposite where we will have a high of 20 and for a low we will have an unforgiving 5 degrees. Stay inside and make sure to bundle up, Bobcats.
Hi Bobcats, thanks for joining me for today's Eyes on Buffett, where we check out things going in the lives of our Bobcats. On Friday, our gym was filled with 8th graders learning a bit more about different high schools in OPS. It was a high school recruitment day. This is where students preparing for high school were given an opportunity to talk with individuals and counselors from the very schools they may be interested in. We were on location to coverage of this.
And then you can pause down at Career Center, take a class, and you can pause back.
Oh, that way?
13 classes for teams.
We have a lot, and we have a lot of classes.
I've looked at Burke and Central.
Omaha South and Burke.
I looked at Burke and
Benson and Brian.
I looked at Northwest and South.
I looked at Burke, Northwest, and North.
Stephen Hillenburg, the visionary creator of SpongeBob SquarePants, died on Monday. In honor of his memory and the show we all love, today we will be taking a look at some of our favorite SpongeBob songs. Are you ready, kids?
Are you ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain!
I can't hear you!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Oh! Who lives in a pineapple under the sea?
But most of all, I'm...
Hey, settle down.
I'm...
Take it easy.
I'm...
What the scallop?
I'm Goofy Goober!
C-A-M-B-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G
song.
C-A-M-B-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G song. And if you don't think that we can sing it faster, then you're wrong. But it'll help if you just sing along. C-A-M-B-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G
song.
Patrick!
Song! C-A-M-B-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G.
Squidward! Good!
Is all the time. One with a collar, turtleneck, that's the kind.
Jumped out of bed and I ran outside, feeling so extra ecstatic. It's the best day ever. Hope
you've enjoyed this edition of BBTV as much as we've enjoyed producing it. Signing off, this has been Anna. Have a great day, and we'll see you right back here tomorrow for more Buffett News.